In the next video, I will add one more star. It's the grandchild. I will connect it with the child. And I will demonstrate that I also can use B-splines instead of these lines. So the first step, what I do is I add a B-spline to the child object. So this is pretty simple. I start here and draw a curve and close it. So that's all. And now I use the grandchild and say the parent should be the child. So, and now I have to move it from here, from the root, to this point. This point is vertex 7. So I change this to 7. Now I'm here. And the next what I can do is I can now change the direction here. I can use the angle, but I also can use a tangent condition and can say I want align it. When I switch here to 1, then it is exactly what I want. Sometimes it's the inverse direction, so I have here a flag tangent inverse, and so I can toggle between both directions, but I think this is enough. And now we have here the condition that now this curve goes in tangent to the grandchild. So this is one possibility. I can also move my grandchild back and I think this is an interesting place, because in this situation we have here 3 edges, and now I can align my grandchild here tangent to any of these 3. This is now 2, 1, and now I can switch 2. That means this is this one, and 3 is this one. And I also can switch to the other direction. Okay, let's move to an outer point, to a leaf point here. Okay, what we now can do here, we have demonstrated that the curve of the father can be a B-spline, and now we want to change this curve. We want to replace it by a B-spline. So I start the sketcher. For my model, I have to put the other objects, the other points, away from this point. I delete this first edge, and now I draw a B-spline. I start in the origin, and to get a tangent, I have to click 2 times onto the x-axis, and now I can start with my curve. And in this case, I have only to connect with the rest, and this is a simple model of a simple street. So, and now we have here, there's a mistake, so I have to re-edit it. I see I have to put this one on the x-axis, and the same is I have to delete this constraint, and I have to put this one, this point, coincident to this point. Now there is exact mapping, and we see here we have joined both curves, and we have here the tangent constraint between the 2 curves. So that's all.